Hi, in this tutorial I show you Z-leveling for Delta printers. After connecting the printer, deactivate auto-leveling with M321 and click on Home. Bring the extruder down so that the sliders are approximately at rod height. Center the extruder with G131. With M99X0, you stop the motor of the X slider for 10 seconds. Put a rod between the bottom and the motor and then press the motor down in this time. After that, you can remove the rod. When you have done this, repeat this for the Y and Z slider so that they have all the same distance to the bottom. Enter G132 S1. That will measure the required offsets. S1 additionally stores the result in EEPROM, so you do not need to repeat it again. After the end stops are calibrated, you can run the bed leveling routine. Now we want to make sure that the tilt of the bed gets corrected. For this, we enter G32 S2 to make it permanent and let the printer test the three measurement points and then home again. Here we see the distances we have just measured. They are close together so that the bed is nearly horizontal. If we now make a map of the measured heights, these should be close together. The transformation matrix also shows we have nearly no rotation necessary and our printer height is 595 mm. To make it easier and faster, we now bring our extruder close to the bed with G1Z5, since we know it is nearly balanced, and then we start our bed height map tool. Enter the area where we want to measure the points and also the number of points we want to measure. Then click Measure Heights. Here at the bottom, we see the measured heights of all points. Also watch out that Z correction is zero if you have any Z correction at all. This appears if you have set Z correction compiled in. But for this first test, we want the height map without correction. When measurement is finished, we have the height map, which is more or less irregularly. Maybe we have a slight rotation along this axis. We also see that minimum and maximum values are close together. Click Result to Clipboard to copy the results and insert it into a text editor to watch the exact values. At this side, they are a bit higher and here lower, but that's okay for now. We now want to enable Z correction. Enter G29 to measure a distortion matrix, in this case 7x7 points, which will be used to correct our bed positioning, so at the first level we have a better connection. And then when we go higher, the correction is taken against zero. When finished, we get a correction matrix. Mark it, click copy and insert it into a text editor. We see that we have the biggest correction corresponding to the biggest values in our first measurement, so we should get a quite good correction. To test this, enter G1 Z5 to go to 5 mm height. Open bed height map and measure again. Now we see measurement contains the correction, which should bring all values much closer together. Here we see no rotation or anything else. Copy it again to clipboard and paste it into a text editor. We see all values are very close together. Only at the edges, which are always the hardest part, we see some slight deviations. With these values, we should have a good bonding to the bed, so that leveling is finished and we can start printing.